Let's see.
A competition or something, yeah. Because you're trying to win, but maybe like, or just us, but it's
yeah, okay. What makes you train? That's what we're in for. What to win.
Well, that's a good idea.
He doesn't train, he actually doesn't. When he's fired, he doesn't start to win. He starts not to lose, and that's the big difference. It's true. There's a massive difference in mentality in that.
He's sitting down off of the
time. If he's fired to win, at least you're worried for stuff. If you spar up to lose, it's really boring. Because the other one just carries up. You can't do anything, they can't do anything, because they just boxed up. And it's like 5 minutes of wasted time.
Side.
Oh, is that pinning yourself flat otherwise.
Paddy, you don't want to walk on, it's all fine.
Yeah, should have rolled then. Walk on, let's try and roll this back into the yard.
I thought you weren't like you were going to roll me then.
Don't keep in this position while he's in this position.
Yeah,
I've no chance. Yeah, I panic straight away. I mean, as soon as I'm in this position, he's got ready to stagger. Getting touch side. Yeah. Once me, I'm all right now. No panic, I'm relaxed. Yeah. I'm going. But once I'm beside the feet, I'm not staring with back. I panic out with back straight away. Sometimes I'll go to practice, you know, be able to put me in the hook in. But I don't mind being on the flat back to me.
Yeah, you can put the press in front of
me. Yeah. I mean, that's not happening to you at his last competition, is it?
Well, yeah, he's back.
Yeah, he's got a pin in this position. Underhooked on the wrong side, and then locked himself in. And that was it then for the rest of the 4 minutes.
He had chest problems. Saying these little drills where you sort of walk up light and just as important, if you allow yourself to go in the positions where we would normally go, I mean, you know,
well, it's good for both players,
yeah,
it?
Exactly.
You're putting yourself into that position, so you can get out of it, he's doing it so you can get,
yeah, you learn so much from doing these things, you know, because what you'll find is that no matter how good your Dillarima is, eventually you'll find a way out of it, and then you've got to adjust your Dillarima accordingly. Start reading what they're doing. You know what I mean? That's why I love these drills.
Okay. Like when you watch me on Wednesday, I'll let you get a mark. I know you didn't actually got a mark because I got my legs up.
Yeah,
he didn't give me a mark. When I put all my weight on his chest, he clapped. As soon as he smacked, that's it. He just went, when I put my arm underneath, he got the rub off my ear. Well, I'm sorry, mate. But if that's the way, when he went, I know I'd get armed, but I'm going to go for it.
Off you go, come on.
You've got an ear lock.
Twist his ear. Well, I've done that before with my legs.
That's why you need to expose yourself to as many shoes.
You might as well expose yourself here in the competition.
Well, that's why, right. Or even worse, forget the competition.
Well, then roll them over, you guys.
Think about spinning their eyes.
Well, you've got the other one as well, where you can just bring them in and flip them over. So.
Well, I was going to do that, now I'm supposed to go to Chris.
Sorry.
Miles work.
Chris. Okay, anyway, so
yeah, well, then it's falling up there.
Yeah.
Be careful, you might be standing on there.
What eyes?
Bradley does that. I mean, that's his technique. To be honest, he purposely leaves it out, knowing they're going to brace, and then he pins his head up from there, isn't it? So what he does this. Puts his head on this side. Drops it up, so then he goes for the back. I mean, purposely does that. If you look at Marcelo Garcia, Marcelo Garcia very much cut off this view. What he tends to do, he seems, once he's got that hook in, he brings it to the leg back. Because then when he does that, he can push it and he nearly gets a knife off it.
I'll tell you what.
You ever seen Marcelo Garcia? Freak, slow it down in slow motion, right? It's ridiculous the power he gets into it off that leg. Because he doesn't just sweep up. He's honestly. Yeah, he's the power, and he's a small guy, but he's so far, and he goes like that, and as he lifts and goes that, you can see him in the air. You think that's ridiculous, that's ridiculous power. But the reason he gets it is because what he does when he won, he pushes off this foot here, he brings it back, pushes off that, and he fully connects to it, he really pushes it. So pushing up that leg, there's a lot of power in it, and that's far more stable than this. So to him doing this, you see, I'm relying on pushing off it in, I'm just relying on my weight. Well, if I bring that back, I can push off that leg. I'm telling you the sweep. So it gives that extra power. It's a really nice thing to do. It's a good strategy. Trap the side one, turn it into the back. That goes up. Because you don't need that then, because you can't pass on this side because you've got the arm on that side. On this side, you're not even bothered if you grab this leg. Because you're trapping here. So it's actually a nice position to be in. Oh, no.